Good morning. First of all, I would like to thank the organizers, not just for going ahead with the conference, but for doing in such difficult circumstances. I also appreciate how you were updating and sharing all your ideas about the conference. I would like to talk about customs controls and the circulation of merchandise in the last years of the 19th century and the first of the 20th century in Spain. This is not a paper on pandemics or quarantines, but on customs inspections, which are regularly applied both in normal times and also during sanitary crises. This is why I consider relevant to talk about customs, merchandise, and economy. In fact, custom controls were mentioned in the regulation approving the state of alarm in Spain on March 2020. Apart from the main objective of virus containment, the law was intended to reduce its social and economic impact. For this reason, customs transits were regulated by law, with an emphasis on the inspections done at the border control posts, and a special focus on facilitating the arrival of staple commodities at ports and airports. The terms economic quarantine, economic containment, and sanitary cordons were widely employed, either claiming for extra measures limiting the circulation of suspicious people or products, or alerting about the long-term economic impacts of sanitary crises. As you know, these terms have been previously used either for supporting military actions or, on the contrary, political isolation. On the other hand, scholars on political economy link the term economic containment with international economic sanctions and still discuss about the effectiveness of such measures to achieve political objectives in different contexts, like the Napoleon Continental System, the League of Nations sanctions against Italy in 1935-1936, or the US sanctions against the Soviet Union in 1980. And an historical example linking customs inspections with political control was pointed out by a Portuguese customs inspector in a book published in 1920. He highlighted how custom experts contribute to the defense of the new republican regime when banning the importation of some boxes of rice powder, showing a portrait of the former king, the royal flag, and other symbols of the monarchy arriving to the Lisbon Custom House. However, this work is not on COVID-19 or other epidemics, but on how importing and exporting merchandise was controlled in late 19th century Spain. Customs are places to exchange people and goods, but also sites to negotiate commercial, fiscal, and economic interests, scientific traditions, and technical standards, and of course, spaces affected by sovereignty tensions. Historians of the territory differentiate about military, legal, diplomatic, natural, geographical, as well as cultural borders, including the linguistic ones. History of science also provides relevant clues to analyze the complex network of people, institutions, and interests existing at customs. Business historians propose the term strategic use of public policy to explain how many regulations were intended to serve more the interests of business people rather than of consumers. The arrival of large amounts of industrial alcohol produced in Central Europe from potatoes instead of from grapes was an example of such strategic use of public policy and economic containment. These artificial alcohols were much cheaper than wine alcohol produced in Spain and other Mediterranean countries, so the price of the domestic wine collapsed. Due to commercial and diplomatic agreement, it was not possible to refrain the imports of German industrial alcohol. The way to stop its importation came from wine producers, which proposed the sanitary solution. Then chemical analysis and custom controls became a decisive tool to reduce the amount of imported alcohol. Because of that, the government also created a central laboratory of chemical analysis run by the Ministry of Finances in 1888. The same problem on alcohols also motivated the creation of chemical laboratories by the custom authorities of other wine producer countries like Italy and Portugal in the same time. Another example shows the variety of experts involved in customs controls. In 1891, a cargo of 184 kilograms of gold impregnated with phenol, as well as 43 kilograms of sterile gold, arrived to the custom inspection point of Valencia de Alcántara, a border city between Cáceres and Portugal. The cargo was cleared as general chemical products by the pharmacy inspector of the town. But he also decided to ask to the Customs Laboratory of Madrid for further advice. These experts, called inspectores de géneros medicinales, were pharmacy inspectors testing the quality, purity, and chemical characteristics of merchandise, mainly in drug, medicine, alcohol, and other substances. They were operating at borders and ports, playing both a fiscal and sanitary role because they provide technical support for revenue collection, but also for public health protection. When a sample arrived to the custom authorities of Madrid, they identified the cargo as sheer fabrics and muslins, which customs taxes were 20 times higher. The new decision was harmful for the importer, possibly a pharmacist, and was published by a pharmaceutical journal titled La Farmacia Moderna. The journal states that importing drugs and medicines like medical gauzes to be employed as fabrics had no sense, resulting in a very over-proportional tax. The journal also blamed both custom authorities and customs inspectors for being the only benefit with the change, because of the extra taxes collected by the government and the amount of the penalty collected by the officials. Apart from the specific details of the Gauzes dispute, the case shows the variety of experts and institutions controlling imports in Spain. Another group of experts working at customs were the delegates of foreign health, delegados de sanidad exterior. They were a group of physicians controlling public health issues and inspecting trains, boats, and people entering or leaving the country. Finally, a third group of experts were the customs officers, Cuerpo Pericial de Aduanas, which was created by the Ministry of Finances in 1850. They were appraisers, inspectors, surveyors, collectors, and other customs officials to control imported and exported merchandise and to calculate its tariff. In case of doubt, both pharmacy inspectors and customs officers could send samples of the merchandise collected to the Laboratory of Madrid for guidance on how to proceed. In the 1920s, the creation of 10 regional customs laboratories in many borders and port cities, due to the increase in trade and economic growth of Spain, added an extra element in the institutional structure in charge of the inspection of merchandise at customs. As I have shown, custom controls fulfill very different purposes, from screening the people crossing the borders, assuring the arrival of essential commodities, banning the exportation of vital products, and even constraining the circulation of ideas. Custom laboratories are part of the custom system. Chemistry was often employed to adulterate many products, and at the same time, government decided to use the same tool to discover and prevent frauds. However, economic protectionism was a more decisive reason to explain the creation or consolidation of many customs laboratories. As happened in Spain, chemical analysis at customs were seen as the sanitary solution against the arrival of industrial alcohol. Then, chemical tests were employed to protect the national interests or at least the interests of powerful industries or economic sectors. Customs are also places of huge scientific activity, involving the work done by a large variety of experts. The arrival of merchandise allowed the Gauzes at the customs of Valencia de Alcántara mobilize different local experts, like pharmacy inspectors and customs officers. In some cases, delegates of foraging health could be also be requested. Also mobilize other institutions, like the government officers and custom chemists, as well as different interests, like the ones pointed out by the pharmacy journal. All of them contribute to both economic and sanitary containment. On the one hand, they discuss about the technical characteristics of the merchandise, its purity, quality, and composition. On the other, the decision had a fiscal and economic impact, or could even result in the restriction on the entry of products. All at all, they were using science to control the circulation of goods at customs, protecting either the interests of the government or private interests. Thank you very much.